Last week, I covered four EV stocks that are better than Tesla, and yesterday, Avis Budget Group, ticker CAR, crushed earnings and was up over 100% in just one day. Today, we're covering four secret bank stocks, and these banks are outperforming the big-name banks like JP Morgan, Bank of America, Citigroup, and Wells Fargo by a huge margin. In fact, one of these banks is up over 800% in the last year, and you've probably never even heard of any of the banks I'm covering today. In today's video, we're going to cover four secret bank stocks better than JP Morgan, my portfolio update and stocks I'm looking to buy, and the crypto minute, including which crypto I just bought. Let's kick things off with a success story from Peggy Ann in our Discord. I found SI on this channel and I'm up over 100%. Woohoo! SI is one of the secret stocks we're covering today, and 100% gains are always nice. And DGSS1 said, I bought Avis Budget based on Jerry's beast mode, purchased at $171, sold a day later at $355. My trailing stop kicked me out for the sell. I then purchased a smaller position and I'm up 3%. Thanks, Jerry. Come on, man. Doubling your money in one day? Yep, that's what happens in our group. Every day you see the success stories we're having, so just ask yourself, what's stopping you from joining our Discord? We have long-term stock picks, swing trades, options, and dedicated channels that will blow you away. All right, now's the time to grab a huge cup of coffee and hang on, because this is not your normal stock channel. Today's Wednesday, and I have to look for a new condo to buy or rent here in Thailand, so I wanted to crank out a quick video for you, so I'm gonna keep this one really short and to the point. Let's jump into the charts, and be sure to check out the Beast Mode scorecard on the left-hand side. Since I said that we're looking at four stocks that are better than JP Morgan, let's quantify that. So right now we're looking at JP Morgan, and what I want to point out is over the last 3 months, JP Morgan is up 13%, and over the last year, they're up 70%, which is pretty good, but I'm going to show you how much better we can do. We'll also note that they're paying a 2.3% dividend yield, and they've got a revenue growth forecast of 19.4%. If we jump down into our indicators on the momentum dream, we can see our momentum is up, which is a good thing, but we're in a neutral zone right now where we're neither in green or red. And if we come down to the buy zone indicator, which is currently in testing, our short-term trend is bearish. We're in the warning zone and we even picked up a sell alert. So right now I would not be buying JP Morgan. We're now looking at Triumph Bank, ticker TBK, and let's look at our TOS bar right here at the top, where JP Morgan was 13 over 3 months and 70 over 1 year. This one is 60% over 3 months and 188% over 1 year, and they've got a revenue growth forecast of 35.1%, so they have absolutely blown away JP Morgan, and it's only going to get better from here. If we look at the momentum dream indicator, our momentum is up and we are stacked positive, which means we're looking for a buy signal. And if we come over to the right, we got a green dot, which is the first day of our buy zone. And if we scroll back just a little bit, we can see they had a real nice squeeze. We'd love to get in then. And then we can see that the stock absolutely took off. So we're hoping for something similar. If we come down to the buy zone, our trend is bullish. We are in the buy zone. And yesterday we picked up a buy alert. So this is one stock you definitely want to consider buying. Now let's look at our risk management bar. And this gives us a complete trading plan. And we've got what I call the golden question. Will I risk $81 and buy 10 shares for $1,221. Our target price would be $134.23. Your recommended trail stop is 7%, and your profit per share would be $12.16. And this is based on a risk to reward ratio of 1.5, meaning for every $1 you risk, you want to get back $1.50. And if you're wondering why you're only risking $81, that's because you have a 7% trail stop on the $1,221, which is 10 shares that you're buying. Our second bank that we're looking at today is Hanmi Financial, ticker HAFC. And over 3 months, we can see that they're up 27% and 1 year, 154%. Looking at our risk management bar, our golden question is, will I risk $95 and buy 54 shares for $1,259? Our target price would be $12.95, trail stop 8%. And if we come down to the momentum dream indicator, our momentum is up. We love buying when we're in the green zone, and we recently had a buy signal. Our trend is currently bullish and we are still in the buy zone. And if you want to grab my indicators, there's a link for them down below. Up next, we've got Customers Bank, ticker CUBI, and this is what we love seeing, everything in bright green across the top. In the last 3 months, they're up 49%. In the last year, 297%, which is insane, and their revenue growth forecast is 30.2%. Our golden question, will I risk $98 and buy 22 shares for $1,233? Put your trail stop at 8%. On the Momentum Dream Indicator, our momentum is up, and we are stacked positive, looking for buy signals. And on our buy zone, the trend is bullish and we are still in the buy zone. And if we look at the buy zone indicator, if you check out our last three buys, we've got 1, 2, and 3. Check out how much of this movement we would have captured. A huge movement all the way from, looks like about $40 all the way up to $56.49. A real nice swing to catch. And our last bank that we're covering today is Silvergate Capital, ticker SI. And these guys are up an insane 805% in the last year. And in the last 3 months, they're up 98%. And check this out. They've got a revenue growth forecast of 94.8%. Our momentum is positive. A squeeze just fired yesterday. And that's right here. And it was coming out of a squeeze, which is the best time to buy and get in early. And this one has really taken off. And it shot up all the way from almost at the 20-day EMA. And this is what we call the ATR3, which is an average true range at 3. And you'll notice stocks aren't at that range very much. So anytime it's that high, I normally wait for it to pull back before I get back into it. Looking at our risk management bar, will I risk $203 and buy 6 shares for $1,222? And you'll notice we've got more risk than we did on the other ones. And that's because our trail stop is set at 17%. And on the plus side, their volume is up 66%. And now we're going to do a portfolio update on some of our positions. We've got NVIDIA, ticker NVDA, and this one's been on fire for us. Our current position is up 21.9%. Looking at the TOS bar in the last month, they're up 33.8%. Our golden question, will I risk $89 and buy 5 shares for $1,320? Your trail stop will be at 7%. And if you don't know NVIDIA, they design and manufacture computer graphics processors, chipsets, and related multimedia software. Looking at our Momentum Dream Indicator, momentum is up. We are in a beautiful buy zone here. We had a buy signal right back here that caught all of this movement. We also had a JR4 buy signal and another buy signal. So this one is serving us well. If you're in this one with us, you might want to tighten your trail stop because we're well above that ATR3. So it will pull back eventually. And when it does, we'll just take our profits. And here's another stock that nobody's really talking about on YouTube that I've seen, and that's Dillard's. It's a department store, ticker DDS. In the last month, they're up 38.6%. Last year, 481%. Our current position is up 18.4%. If we look at the chart here, they've got a nice set of railroad tracks, beautiful upward trend. We picked up a JR3 buy signal right here. We picked up another JR3 buy signal yesterday. Coming down to our Momentum Dream Indicator, momentum is up, a nice buy zone. However, the momentum has been going down, so we're kind of neutral right now. And then on our buy zone indicator, we had a buy zone right here, caught a real nice part of that movement, and we picked up another buy zone indicator 2 days ago. Tighten up your trail stops if you're in on this one. Same thing as the last stock. And the last stock I wanted to show you is Avis Budget, ticker CAR. They were up 108% yesterday. I mean, they absolutely took off from right around $177, $178 all the way up to $545. And then they closed out the day right here at $357. And I covered this stock just a couple of days ago, right around this time. I think it was on the 27th. A great time to get in it right before this big movement. And now it's time for the Crypto Minute. And in this segment, I just go through 2 or 3 different coins to see if anything looks good to buy or sell. No hype, no drama, just technical analysis made easy.
We're starting with Bitcoin today, and right now we can see they're down about 0.57% from yesterday. Looking at the Momentum Dream Indicator, we are in the red zone, which is a warning zone. And on my buy-sell indicator, we can see that the short-term trend is bearish, and we're also in the warning zone. So this is a pass for me today. For Ethereum, we're on a 1-day chart. We can see we've got a real nice bullish run here on the daily. Looking at the Momentum Dream Indicator, we just entered the green zone in the last day. And if we come down to the buy sell indicator, you can see 1, 2, 3, our last 4 buy signals right here captured a really nice movement. And our short-term trend is bullish and we're in the buy zone. So this is on the 1-day chart. And I did buy Ethereum yesterday. So let's pop over to the 4-hour chart. We are definitely in the buy zone on the Momentum Dream. We had a squeeze going on, and then we came out of that squeeze and fired. And then if we come down to the buy sell indicator, we picked up a buy signal right here, and I bought right in that time frame, and you can see we're up and running off to the races. And this is how I use the indicator. Bought Ethereum yesterday, added to my current positions. We're now looking at Shiba Inu, and we can see in the last couple of days, over the last 8 days, it is down 25.35%. And the funny thing is, I've been picking up a lot of haters on YouTube because they think I'm down on Shiba. Well, I'm not. I actually own Shiba. I'm hoping that it goes big time, and I'm looking to buy more. But if there's not a buy signal, there's not a buy signal, and that's what I've been covering. So haters, keep the hate coming. I enjoy it. Makes things interesting. No worries there. So looking at our chart right now, we can see that our momentum is down. We got the Momo down on the dream indicator. And then if we look at the buy sell indicator, we can see that our short-term trend is neutral. Let's pop on over to the 4-hour chart. And what do we see? Well, we've got the short-term trend is bearish and we're in the warning zone right now. So this is not a time that I would be buying. And if we look at the chart, it makes sense. So right now we're simply waiting for green on green on the daily chart and hopefully green on green on the 4-hour chart. And that could be a good time to buy. And if we go back just a little bit, you can see we had a buy signal right here, turned out really well, and a buy signal right here, that one would have turned out great. And that's a wrap on the Crypto Minute.
Thanks for hanging out with me today. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you want some free stocks, free crypto, or to earn up to 8.6% interest on your money, check out the links in my description below. Peace, and I'll see you soon on the next video.